But the one who does not know and does things deserving punishment will be beaten with few blows. From everyone who has been given much, much will be demanded or required. And from the one who has been entrusted with much, much more will be asked. Huh?
Yes.
For the ones who have a little bit, much more will be required.
Well,
now you know you can take a little bit and do a lot with it.
Amen.
I remember back in the days I had 5 children. I still have 5 children. And I could take a little bit of food.
Bless it.
And feed every one of them and me too.
Bless it.
But we didn't have no leftovers.
Have mercy.
So at that time, you know, not too many people could feed guests.
Amen.
And I would tell my children, you bring anybody home, whatever, I'm gonna fix your food on your plate, then I'm gonna give half of it to whoever you brought.
Amen.
Because I would not let nobody be hungry. So if you don't want a full plate of food, then bring company. So all my right. kids never brought nobody home. Because they knew that's how it was gonna be. Because at that time, we didn't have a lot of stuff.
Amen.
We didn't have a lot of stuff. And when you was trying to raise 5 children by yourself, a lot of things you had to do without.
Amen.
Even working 2 jobs, it was hard to make ends meet. But guess what? We never went hungry.
Bless it.
God kept a roof over our heads.
Bless it.
Huh? Every one of my children got a high school diploma. If they didn't go no further, they had to get a high school diploma.
Bless it.
Huh? So we got what we needed.
Amen.
Because you know why? Because he told us he would supply our every need. According to his riches and glory. In Christ Jesus. Huh?
Amen.
Are you needed tonight?
Amen.
Are you in need of something tonight?
Oh, have mercy.
He said, supply your need. He said, all you got to do is ask.
Yes.
I stand at the door waiting for you to knock.
Yes, it is.
So you can ask for what you want.
Amen.
But you know, some people don't know how to ask.
Amen.
Huh? They're afraid if they ask that he won't deliver.
Good.
Huh? And he's just like, he has more power than the mailman. See, the mailman delivers only once a day.
Well.
But God delivers everything.
Come on, sir.
And all through today. All through today. Glory. Hallelujah.
Bless it.
Our next word is remission.
Remission.
And we'll get that from Matthew 26 and 28.
Remission.
And you know what that says? This is my blood of the covenant, which is poured out for many for the forgiveness or remission of sin. Huh?
Amen.
When we be remissioned.
All right. Nick.
When we are remissioned.
My God. Start up.
Are forgiven.
Yeah.
Huh?
Start up.
For whatever we've done.
Yeah.
God says he'll forgive us for everything but one thing.
My God.
Blaspheme against the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Now if you blaspheme against the Holy Spirit, you know where you're going.
My God.
You know where you're going. But that's the only sin you won't be pardoned for. But everything else, God, Jesus died for. Huh? Jesus died. When he went on the cross, he took all our sins with him.
Yes.
He didn't leave not one back here.
My God.
He took them all with him.
Amen. Huh? Thank you, Lord.
And when he died and went in the grave, you come up with all power in
all
heaven.
Power.
All power in heaven. All power. Let this be written for a future generation that a people not yet created may praise the Lord.
Yes.
How can a people not yet created praise the Lord?
Have mercy.
He's letting us know if we don't praise him,
somebody
he'll have the babies in the womb praise him.
Yeah.
Huh?
Come on,
he'll
man.
He'll have the mountains praise him.
Yes,
he'll
Lord.
He'll have the rocks to praise him.
Yeah.
He'll have the trees to praise him.
Yeah.
He'll have these walls if you don't praise him.
Amen.
He'll have these walls to talk back to him.
Yes, you will.
Amen.
So that's why we must praise him.
Well,
that's how he asked me. Praise him. Lift up your hands and praise him.
Yes, Lord.
And call him by his name.
Jesus.
Call him by his name.
Oh, Jehovah.
Oh, glory. Hallelujah.